I'm Janine Jackson. I'm the head of the fundraising department here at the Children's Hospital at Westmead. Our job is each and every year to raise $30 million for the hospital. The money that we raise goes to upgrading for equipment, essential staff, counsellors, the list goes on, and also our important research in order to improve kids' health. The fundraising department's going through a massive transition. Our job is to go from $30 million to $50 million. So the hospital needs a significant improvement from the fundraising team.
My name's Alex Jones. I'm a regional director at Hayes.
I'm Jane Donnelly. I'm senior regional director here in New South Wales.
My name's David Cawley. I'm one of our regional directors at Hayes.
We're doing our final AMP module, and the charity we're working with was the Children's Hospital at Westmead.
The objective was a really simple one, so it was to try and take the fundraising team's target forward from 20 to 50 million as quickly as possible.
But I think for also us at Hayes, it was about learning about our leadership and our management skills, and so it was a lot about us as well as leaders.
It was a big challenge, so we started off by interviewing a lot of people throughout the fundraising team and throughout the hospital, and really a lot of external stakeholders as well.
There were a whole host of different things around the team, the setup, the team morale, how they went about trying to generate funds that actually got us really interested.
And then it was really coming out with two key insights as to what we felt were the core issues as to why they weren't delivering as well as they could be.
At points were quite challenging because you were dealing with very sensitive stakeholders. So, you know, from parents who maybe had a bereavement that was linked to the hospital, right the way through to doctors maybe who didn't necessarily understand or was their first concern about fundraising for the hospital.
So it was really walking in their shoes and really immersing ourselves to really get an understanding of what the core problems were, and then coming up with solutions for that.
What we learned through that journey was there were a whole host of different viewpoints from the stakeholders, and we had to narrow it down into one or two key things. So we came up with two insights.
The terminology we used around it was about the bureaucracy, and then we sort of called that bureaucracy the monster, so that was sort of within the hospital, and that they were feeding that bureaucracy, and that bureaucracy was getting in the way of, I suppose, the team doing the best job that they could do.
The other issue was that we felt that they'd actually lost, we kind of termed it, they'd lost their heart, and they'd almost lost the whole purpose of why they were there, which was the children.
The perceptions that they came back with were different from what we actually saw being here every day.
We actually presented to the fundraising team and the key stakeholders and also some parents, and we actually did it in a storyboard form. I'm a drawer, I'm a very visual person, and it was late the night before our presentation and people were talking and I was just drawing pictures of what they were talking about.
So we told a story of this monster that was bureaucracy and went through stages and then how to tame it. That showed them quite clearly and in pictures and in some words about, you know, some of the things that they were struggling with, this bureaucracy, and how they could manage it and how they could tame it, and some recommendations around that. We then also did a storyboard for the heart, and we had some hearts about the heart of the fundraising team and how they had to find that again and what was their purpose and what was their sort of key reason for being the fundraising team.
The Hayes people were the first that actually really got it and were able to communicate it in a way that everybody understood what were the hurdles and what we needed to do.
2 days after the presentation, the monster and the heart were bought and were brought into the hospital and were immediately kind of part of the team.
We're creating a monster award. We've actually bought Sully from Monsters Inc, and he gets handed around the office at our team meeting. We also have a gorgeous little gorilla, which is a heart, and then we also have a bell.
We recommended that they need to celebrate success more and ring bells when they get money in and shout about it, and I was there and they were actually doing this. It was great to hear someone running outside their office and going, "I've got a check for $10 million. And everyone coming out and celebrating with them. So that was really good to see that.
The most exciting thing in dealing with the Hayes staff is they really got engaged wholeheartedly. It has had the desired impact that I thought it would do.
And it's demonstrated what good leadership we all have, and our ability to adapt and take on lots of information and come up with some really good strategies.
We did work around vision and about creating vision and how to come up with a vision and what a vision is. And I think I've taken that back into my business and now can have a vision for my teams and where I want my business to go, and also about getting people on board with that vision.
I've also seen the engagement with my direct management team improve because I feel I'm more consultative of them now. I take on board their viewpoints more, and it's really taking the theory that we went through when we were in the hospital and applying that to everyday life.
I think it's fantastic that Hays has dedicated six of their senior management team to support a non-Hays organisation, and I think that's really added a real value to what, how I feel about Hays.
They were incredible people that really went above and beyond to try and help us. So, what can I say but thank you?